Or maybe I dreamt that. The more I look at it, the more I want it, but I should not. That's the gist of it. Yes, let's go. Oh yeah, let's next go to this. Let me take a sip of water. Yeah. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today is another installment of my Let's Talk Makeup new makeup releases. I am filming this pretty early because I like it that way. And then I have I have a little bit more time to edit everything. So I'm filming this on Tuesday. So if there are things sneak peeked between now that I'm filming this on Tuesday afternoon and Friday evening, for me at least, when the video goes online, I have seen it, but it's not in the video. So yeah, that is it. Also, my bags are apparently very apparent today. I don't know why, but they came out to play, I think. So yeah, this is a recurring series on my channel based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist and the community playlist are both in the description box, as is my own playlist of these videos. And yeah, what I have on my eyeballs is the Catrice, what is it? Pro Slim Eyeshadow Palette in Peach Origin. I'm filming two looks, and this is look number one that I have on the eyeballs. So a video on that is coming. If you want to see my thoughts and are not subscribed yet, make sure that you have hit the subscribe button and then the bell button, so you will be notified when the video goes live. I also filmed a bunch of other videos today and yesterday, so a lot of fun stuff is coming on my channel, in case you are curious why. So let me go to the side and grab my water, open up my Instagram. There. I have quite a few things to get through, I think, at least. Okay, let's go to Hip Dot, because no. Thank you. I don't know why I don't have an... Well, basically, Hip Dot have collaborated with Hello Kitty, and I thought I saw somewhere, I could be mistaken though, but I thought I saw somewhere that Colourpop was going to collaborate with Hello Kitty as well. Or maybe I dreamt that. I don't know. But yeah, they have collabed with Hello Kitty. So there is an eyeshadow palette, a 9-pan palette, which looks cute. Looks springy. You can get the full collection that includes the bag for $74. Oh, it's a lip gloss duo for $14, I think. Then Kitty Eyes eyeliner and mascara duo, also $14. A Hello Kitty selfie palette for $24. And a Hello Kitty heart sponge for $10. Yeah, it launches March the 30th. 12 p.m. PST on Hip Dot and Sanrio, and will launch later this week on Ulta Beauty. I think this is fun. I'm not specifically very much into Hello Kitty, but I do like it. It's a kitty. What's not to like? And it's girly. Yeah, I do like it. Am I going to get it? No, but I do like it. Let me know. Maybe you are very much excited. Let's go next to, I think it is a new brand, right? Let's see. Yes, it's a pretty new brand. They are based in the UK and I just found them. I don't know why I found them, but I found them. This is a picture of their... oh, they are called Endangered Cosmetics. And this is a picture of their Red Panda palette. It is £34 and it will be available for purchase on their website midnight 30 March, the 30th of March. So it is... Oh, that's today as I'm filming this. So today it's going live. I also saw that 10% of the proceeds of their sales go to a wildlife conservation. And I think that is an amazing cause. Yeah, I love red pandas. Truly, they're just... They're so, so cute. But I also have swatches. And I really like the look of these swatches. I think that the color story is very, very pretty. Yeah, and I think it captures the color story of the red panda as well. I do have to say, though, that £34 for me right now is a little bit too pricey. But I am very, very curious. And I am definitely keeping my eyes on this brand. I cannot wait to see what they are doing next. It's, yeah, I really like the way that the panda palette looks. Let me know if you know the brand. Let me know. Maybe you have even ordered the palette. Let me know down below. I think it's very, very pretty. Okay, let's next go to Catrice, because I have a few things from Catrice. I have this one, which is the long-awaited, now finally here, their former online exclusive, the Nude Peony Pressed Pigment Palette, has been reborn and is now part of their standard assortment. Apparently, a lot of people asked for this, and I understand it. Is that a glitter? I hope not. I don't know if Catrice does press glitters in their palettes, though. I do not think so, but I'm not sure. I understand why people love this palette, this color story. The palettes that I have tried so far from Catrice are very nice quality. This is not specifically something that I go for. And to be honest with you, it is what I have this as well. So it's not, I have seen this palette before, but it was not interesting enough for me to pick up. But it is permanent right now. So that is good. Then the next thing that I will mention is from Catrice. This is actually kind of old news here in Europe, at least on Cosmetic for Less, but that's not what I want to mention. So here is their collaboration with Disney, which launched last year here in Europe. I saw it and I was like, do I want to get anything? But it was not just not it at that time for me. So they are coming to the, or they are in the US. That was what I was, wow, it's so difficult today. But they have launched on the US site from Catrice and they should be at Ulta very, very soon. It says here currently on the website in the new arrivals section. So you get an eyeshadow palette. What is this? Ursula. You get the Evil Queen, because they have done the villains, the Evil Queen, yeah. And are those the only two that are on there? Because I know that the collection featured more. They had more palettes. They also had some face palettes, if I'm not mistaken. But the post that I have here is only the two palettes. So I will leave the Catrice US site down below for you to check out. Let me know your thoughts down below. Do I know what they retail for? It says so here, $14 each. Okay, let's next go to Lashes by Lina. And I mentioned this brand last week as well with their Nigeria collection. This is their Louisiana-inspired B palette. She says here, I have seen so many brands do a honey-themed palette. Had to try my twist to it and honor their mother's legacy by making her the muse. Yes. The only thing, though, is that I cannot find anything else besides a moving picture of the empty palette. I don't know swatches. I don't know shadows. And it says here that the pre-orders will start March the 15th. Which it has already been, but it's not on the site, so I don't know. It says here expected ship date April 15. I don't know. I don't know anything else. So I really, I'm interested to see what it looks like because yeah, Bumblebee, you know, Bumblebee. But yeah, I don't get this post though because it's not on the site. So how do we pre-order then? And I don't want to pre-order without having seen the shadows and swatches as well. Does that make any sense? Am I alone in that? Let me know down below. But I am very much interested to see the final color story. Let's next go to Ofra Cosmetics. And I mentioned this last week. Basically it was announced between me filming it and you watching it. So it is the Life's Draft collection, the second collaboration that they have done with Samantha March, and it's just amazing. So it is a palette, a complete palette, so eyeshadows and face shades, lip gloss trio as well. So it's a complete collection, and I think it is amazeballs. Let's see, the palette is the Mini Mix Face Palette called Life's a Draft. It retails for $39, which I don't think is a bad price at all. And then the Lip Gloss Trio retails for $29. And you can get the PR box. And that includes a sticker sheet for $59. Yeah, it's just very much her. I was actually watching her reveal video and basically talking about the complete collection when I was doing my makeup. So I haven't had the opportunity to watch the entire video yet. But I do really like it. I like the shades that she selected. I think it is very, very much her. Am I picking it up? I kind of want to, but not right now. I know that with her last collab, it will come to Boozy Shop, because that's what happened with her last collab. It came to Boozy Shop here in the Netherlands and it came to Beauty Bay. So Yeah, I'm going to wait for that. It's this is the same as the Club Nebula palette. If I'm buying this, I'm buying it for me and because I want to support Samantha March. That's it. Not specifically to review or anything, because by the time that that I'm getting it, everyone has already reviewed it and it's basically old news, you know, because it just goes so quickly. So yeah, again, if I'm going to get anything from this, it is just for me. But I like it. Yeah, I like it a lot. I like the whole theme. I like everything about it. I will link her video where she talks about it down below. Let me know if you are excited, if you have gotten it. It did sell out. Round one sold out pretty quickly, if I'm not mistaken. But they are scrambling to restock it. So yeah. Okay, let's next go to Be Wicked cosmetics, because a little while ago I mentioned these that I did not know what they were, but that I thought that they were very, very pretty, and that I thought that maybe they were highlighters. They are not highlighters, they are lash cases. So basically they are launching new lashes in these cases, and I think it's so cute. I think the component is just so, so cool. I will link her website down below. I don't know when they will come. If I know by the time this video is live, it will be in the description box. Okay, let's next go to Alien Cosmetics, because I have some things from them. Oh yeah, just a quick update. Last week I mentioned that the Fairy Frolic palette was out of stock when I ordered the Strawberry Milkshake palette. I contacted the owner and she has added it to my order. So both palettes are on the way to me. Just saying. So yeah, and I have an affiliate code with Alien Cosmetics as well. I did pay for both palettes myself though, in case you were curious. Okay, let's go to this. This is the low light highlighter palette. The artwork is done by Missu Pacey, and she also did the artwork for the Bunnies palette, if I'm not mistaken. This is 6 multichrome highlighters. The pans are 50mm by 50mm, and it's specifically formulated to work on deep skin tones. Yeah, the shadows are very, very pretty. Very pretty. I will leave her in the website down below, but I will also leave Hayden's YouTube channel down below. And Hayden is the owner, and she has her own YouTube channel, and on the YouTube channel she uses this, so you can see how they look. But they are very, very, yeah, it's very, very pretty. Next, what is also coming soon are lashes. That's it. I see a box and I see the artwork, and that's it. Lashes. I love lashes. So I'm very, very excited to see that. I don't know what they will retail for. I don't know if this is the only one, or if she will have more shades or styles. I don't know. Let's next go to a new brand for me, which is Metamorphosis BF. Yes. A few of my friends mentioned this brand because of the giraffe face paint, if I'm not mistaken. But I saw this, and one of you commented that you love everything panda. So when I saw this, I was like, I know I need to talk about this. This is Panda Powder Bronzers. You see the shades from left to right. It's the shade Panda. The middle shade is 1864. And then the last shade is Bamboo. They are highly pigmented. They blend like butter, and they are available now. I also have swatches. I don't know. Yeah, the picture I'm looking at is pretty dark. Just based on, I think the light has turned down so you can see the shades a bit better. But yeah, I just wanted to mention this. I think it's fun. I don't know what they retail for though. But I will leave the site where you can get them down below. I think they're cute. Yes, let's next go to half-caked makeup. Yeah, I saw some things on their Instagram that I was very interested in, actually, because they have cream bronzers that you can also use as highlight, no, as contour. Let me know if it's a brand that I need to check out, because then I can kind of look into it. But they are releasing this. This is the No Chill Luster highlighter. It will release the 2nd of April at 10 a.m. EST, and there will be 5 shades. That's it. But I thought I also had the picture of this shade. Didn't I? I don't know. But they have more things. They have blushes. They have, oh yeah, here I have a picture of a shade. So let me save that so I can show you. which is basically a goldeny, I don't know. But they have eyeshadow palettes. The eyeshadow palettes, yeah, they look okay. But I was actually pretty interested in the bronze cream bronzers. Let me know if they are worth it. Because then I can kind of look into it and see if I can get them. It says here, shop Urban Outfitters, Ipsy of Amazon. And their own site. I don't know if one of these is more Europe-based though. I need to check that. Let me know if it's worth it, this brand. Because they're pretty big. But I never truly heard of them. I don't watch a lot of Ipsy unboxings either. So maybe that is it. Let me know if you are excited. Okay, let's next go to Makeup Brand Alert. This is Colorfiend. It's a new beauty brand based in the US. They are cruelty free and vegan. And this is their 90s eyeshadow palette. It has 12 shades with a mix of mattes and shimmers. It will launch the 9th of April. I just don't know a price. But I think it is a fun, summery, bright palette. Yeah, I think it's fun. It looks cute. And I like them. I like the shade names as well. Waterfalls, yeah, was one of my favorite songs. Still is though. The Matrix, yeah. Yeah, I really like this. I like it. Let me know if you have heard of this brand. Let me know if you are excited. I will leave the information down below. Let's next go to SheGlam because they have released some new things. The Spring It On collection. It is the Clover palette, which is the green palette. Then you get the Bloom palette, which is the rosy palette. You get three cream to powder blushes in three shades, $4 each. Three liquid highlights, $4 each. Four glosses, also $4 each. And let me see. Yeah, the eyeshadow palette, the green one. Yeah, right up my alley. It looks very, very pretty. Not gonna lie. Then the second one, the rosy one. Yeah, it looks pretty as well. I don't really have any swatch. Oh, here's the swatches of the blushes, I think. Right, then. Cream to powder blush flash. Yeah, they. Oh, cream to powder blushes. Maybe I need to try these. I have never tried SheGlam. It's cheap as chips, even for us in the Netherlands, because it is sold at Shine. And they have a Dutch website as well. So yeah, I am going to check this. Damn it, I should not have mentioned this because now I want to try the freaking blushes. Let me know if you have tried them. But yeah, not gonna lie, I will probably get some to try. Okay, let's next go to Sigil. Because last week I mentioned that she was coming out with a new palette, right? And now I have the complete color story. Yeah, so I will just grab a screenshot from the site or something. You will see the palette here. It's a 10-piece palette. They have a big one, a micro size, and the micro size is for reference. Let me show you. So here I have the Naked Kitty Cat palette. This is the normal pen size. Yeah, so the big palette is this pen size. And then she also has the color story split into two. So you can get either one big palette. You can also get two smaller palettes. And she also has a micro size. Here I have a micro size. So this is the pen difference. Can you see that? So if you see on their site, when you click the drop down menu for the palettes, if you see, it's in Russian, I'm well aware. However, you see two types of numerals in there. You see 10, the numeral 10, and then you see either 26 or 13. Is that correct? No, you see 10, and then in the 10, you need to look. Wow. When you go to the drop-down menu on her site, unless you want the 5 pen palettes, ignore where it says 5 in the title because it's the numeral 5. Go to the numeral 10 and then pick. If you see numeral 10 and then 26 in the same sentence, it's the big pen sizes. It's also the most expensive one. If you see 10 and then 13 in the same line, it is the micro size. That is it. That's how you can that's how I quickly tell the difference. Yeah, that's it. It's frustrating, I know, but it is the way that I do it. So yeah, this color story is pretty light. It's pretty neutral. I'm like, yeah, I don't want it. I don't need it. It's not something that I want to grab. I did not grab it on release, and it has released last Sunday. It released, and it is probably sold out. The annoying thing is, though, the more that I look at it, the more I want it, and the more I kind of want to complete the set. You know, the trouble is, though, her palettes aren't cheap, guys, and that is what I sometimes usually forget because the price is in ruble, but. Yeah, it's not cheap. The bigger 10 pan palettes are, I think, around $60. That's pretty hefty. They're an amazing quality, not gonna lie. But yeah, if I'm bitching about a $65 dollar palette from Natasha Denona, I should kind of bitch about this as well, shouldn't I? But that's the trouble with it. It's you buy the whole experience, or at least for me. And because the price is in ruble, it's just so deceptive. You know? So... I haven't ordered this one. I wasn't really planning on ordering this one. I'm still waiting for her to restock the Windrose. And I know that a lot of you still wait for her to restock the Chinchilla one as well. I don't know when. I wish that instead of constantly releasing new things, almost like Colourpop, she would restock the palettes that people want. Kind of like Colourpop. But yeah, I don't know. Maybe it is a problem with the pigments that they are hard to come by. I don't know. But yeah, maybe let me know if you have picked up the palette. I'm curious to know. I haven't. Yes, it's very, very pretty. The more I look at it, the more I want it. But I should not. That's the gist of it. Yes, let's go. Yeah, let's go to this. Because this was also new and I was tagged in this. This is from Beauty Mark Cosmetics. And this is their... they will rebrand and launch on April the 3rd. But yeah, it's a very cute collection. That was what I wanted to talk about because it's Kitty Cat. That's why I was tagged as well. So it's a Kitty Cat Nico Tails palette, which looks cute. Yeah, I like the color story and looks like also three lippies. And there are some paw earrings. It's their cat collection. Yeah, it's palette, glosses, and handmade cat paw earrings. And I will leave her information down below in the description box. When is this launching? Is this a joke? Never mind. This is from Cursed Cosmetics. This is their Brewing Spells spellbook palette. And that is why I said, is this a joke? Because it is launching on April the 1st. So yeah. But I only see the outside. I don't know what the inside is. So it could very well be that I will talk about it again next week. It contains 15 eyeshadows. It's vegan and cruelty free. And I don't know anymore. I don't know. If I know more, I will let you know. It's probably going to be next week then. Okay. Let's next go to this from Hank and Henry. This is a collab between Hank and Henry Beauty and Bianca Loves Makeup 91 on Instagram. It's the Bianca bundle. It's the tie-dye collection. It has two products. It's a palette that contains 20 all matte shades retailing for $45. And then a mirror retailing for $25. The bundle is $60. It has launched already. Swipe for more pictures. Yes, she looks amazing. Gorgeous. I don't know her though. Not gonna lie. But congratulations on your collab. It looks amazing. I like the mirror. I'm not a hand mirror type of person because I'm too lazy to hold it up. I like the color story of the palette. It's a rainbow palette. Yeah, I like it. I don't necessarily go for an all matte palette, but I know that there are a lot of people are. Yeah, I like it. Let me know if you are interested and if you are excited about the collab. Oh yeah, let's next go to this. Let me take a sip of water. Yeah. To be quite honest, the videos that I have seen, I have not heard anyone liking this collection, which is from NYX, the Tetris collection. Now, first off, I love Tetris. I have played Tetris so much back in the day on the Game Boy and on the computer and on the phone. I truly, truly loved Tetris. This though, I don't get it. What do they have? They have red circle parts around some of the pans, making basically the shapes. But it is not so not cohesive at all. You should have the Tetris blocks had the same color. You had a yellow row, or you had a red square. They were the same color, you know? So at least, you know, if you make a square and you want it red, then at least make sure that it is the red family. That you can easily tell that that is that square shape, because this just looks like a big ass tabletop palette that no one asked for, that you can basically buy off of AliExpress as well. This could have been so cool. Truly. I have seen... what indie brand was it? Kraken Cosmetics. They have done Tetris small palettes that they have just basically made the Tetris shapes in color families. Small palettes. They were amazeballs. This, it could have been so much better. But this is not it, Nyx. Yeah, I love you, but this is not it. There's more in the collection though. Let's see, what do we have? Yeah, that big ass palette retailing for $55. It is 80 shades. 80! Wow. Sometimes stuff is too big. Yes, I know what I said. Then they also have lip kits for 8. Angel Food Cake and Praline is one, and then Butter Lip Gloss and Slim Lip Pencil. That's another one. What? Oh, wait. You get a lip gloss and the pencil in the shades Angel Food Cake or Praline. That's it. And then the Epic Ink Liner Kit for 35 shades. White, blue, light blue, pink and yellow. Now, I am interested in that one. I don't know if it's the liquid liner, the Epic Wear. Are those the pencils? Liner sticks. Yeah, I have a few of those, I think. Right? Yeah, liner sticks. Epic Wear liner sticks. Yeah, they are amazeballs. And I don't have the colors that are in here. So, yeah, if that I am interested in. It's the only thing that I am interested in. It's the liners. Truly, truly amazing liners. Let's next go to Certify. We have heard nothing much from Certify for quite some time, but here there is a mega sale going on. It says here, all eyeshadow palettes discounted, less than half the price, the lowest price they've ever been, starting from only $10. It's time we make some space for some newness. Now is the time to take advantage. So if there was anything that you were eyeing from Certify, now is the time. I have two palettes from Certify. I have the Destiny and I have the Eternity. I love the quality, especially of the Eternity, and I think that's a palette that's very underrated. It is basically their rosy toned palette. It's gorgeous. I don't use it a lot, but it's gorgeous. So yeah, I'm very, very excited to see what she is going to do. Very much so. Yeah. Then let's go to Huda. Because she is releasing new palettes. And I know that there is a lot of people bitching about this color story. I have not been into Huda truly for a very, very long time. So basically all the... Yeah, these palettes. I kind of started noticing Huda with the Gemstone Obsession palettes, but that was because I bought dupes on AliExpress and I did not know that they were dupes from Huda. So I saw the ones from AliExpress first and then I ordered a few and then I later found out that they were dupes from her palette. So that is how I found Huda. So that's basically a timeline, you know. I really like the toffee one, the middle one. It's that yellow. Yeah, put in a mustard yellow or an olive green or even both. And I'm here for it. I kind of like the caramel brown too though, because that's a little bit peachy. Hell, I actually like them all. Not gonna lie. But yeah, they retail for, what was it? It's probably $25, something like that. They drop today. Yeah. I don't need them. I'm certainly not going to pay $25 for them. But I really do like the look of, yeah, who am I kidding? I like them all. I'm not going to buy them, but I like them all. If I were to get any, it would be the toffee one, the middle one, because that one caught my eye first. But the longer I look at them, the longer I like, I'm like, I want them, but I shouldn't. I have enough. Yeah. And she's too hit or miss for me. Okay, let's next go to Lethal Cosmetics, because this is a sneak peek movie that I have here. I have basically static on a TV and glitch, and it says soon. And then basically a rebooting thing. So I'm guessing that palette/collection number 3 is in the works. And I cannot wait to see I cannot wait to see. I have the palettes that they released, with the exception of their first, their collaboration palette. I have the other two I have here. So yeah, if this is a palette, you bet your balls that I will really, really want that palette. If I know more, I will let you know. Let's next go to Juvia's place, because they have released new primers. Three colors. They retail for $12. Lightweight eyelid primer, color corrects and smooths. Beautiful canvas, enhance the vibrancy, blendability, wearability and creaselessness of your favorite eyeshadows. And that creaselessness, that's kind of very interesting. You have light, medium, dark. Yeah, I am very, very interested in these. They had a sale going on not too long ago. And if I am not mistaken, if they are having a sale, you can still use discount codes, because you can kind of stack codes. I don't have a code, but there are codes out there. Let me know if you are excited. Have you tried these? Because I'm curious. Let's next go to Fenty Beauty, because she has dropped some stuff. Let's see here. Oh yes, the blurring, that was it. That's what she dropped, the blurring skin tint. It says here, blurred complexion, few drops for quick everyday coverage in 25 flexible shades. It retails for $29.50. And the claims are instant blurring skin tint, buildable light to medium coverage, long wear coverage, quick blur complex for a hydrating diffused effect. A smooth texture that layers well with primer and skincare, applies well with fingers or brush, humidity, sweat and transfer resistant formula. I have ordered this one. In shade, they don't have an olive shade, but when I shade matched or compared matched on the Fenty site and I compared it with shade 145, which is their light olive, I got shade 3. Match to this one. When I match shade 290, which is the darkest one that I have in their olive, I'm getting matched with 11. So I basically went in the middle a bit. So I think I got shade 5, which is then medium warm undertone. That's the one that I got. I'm actually very, very curious about this. Very curious, because I love the Catrice Instant Perfect. No, what's that thing called? I thought this would be a quick episode, but it's not. Just so you know. But you already knew that. Yeah, this one, the Pretty Natural Hydrating Foundation. This is a light, it's a buildable coverage, but I can get a medium out of it if I work for it. But I do truly like this foundation a lot. So I am very, very interested in the one from Fenty. As I said, I have it on the way. I also ordered her hydrating primer, 30 ml size, because I want to try that one as well. And when I get them, I will compare as well. It's the first true skin tint foundation that I have. I really like her Pro Filter foundation. I really, really like it, especially with a hydrating primer underneath. So I cannot wait to try it with her primer. Yeah, as I said, I ordered this. And it is on the way. Sephora France, I ordered it, and it could very, what is today? Tuesday. It could very well be that I have already had the opportunity to try it by the time you are seeing this, because sometimes they are very, very quick. Okay, let's next go to, let me know if you are excited, if you want me to do, I'm going to do a review anyway. Never mind, because I'm curious to see how it will behave on my older skin. Crappy, whatever. Let's next go to Artist Couture. Why am I talking about Artist Couture? I don't know, but these are Love Sprung face palettes. They have released already. You have version 6 and 7, and they retail for $34 each. I don't know why I wanted to mention them, beside the fact that, yeah, they look pretty. I think I got tagged in this. I usually don't really go for blush palettes. It's not that I'm against them, absolutely not, but I just find that I don't use them enough. I have a few palettes that I actually need to put here so that I can see them and that I don't forget that I have them, because usually I reach for singles. But yeah, they do look pretty. Let me know if you have tried them. They're coming to Sephora in April, that's what it says here. Let me know. Then I think this is the last thing, right? Yeah, this is the last thing that I have for today. This is the from Notorious Artistry Cosmetics. Yes, let's follow. This is a water-activated UV Matte Liner Palette featuring 15 color shades. I don't know if it is available now. Let's see. Link in bio. It is available. Oh, and it is sold out. That was 3 days ago. I don't know if they will restock it though. Oh yeah, restock will come soon. So, do they have more? Oh, I also have swatches. Yeah, they look very, very cool. If you are into this sort of thing, and I've said this before, I like it if it is in a palette. I like it. It's maybe, not for me personally, it wouldn't be hard to store. And I think I would use it more than my loose pots that I have in a drawer somewhere. Because, yeah, out of mind, out of eye, out of sight, out of mind. That was the one I was looking for. I actually still need to bring up my FX water paint kit because I have one. So that's the reason that I don't buy stuff like this. Because I have stuff like that that I don't use. So, yeah, but I like the colors. I like this neon thing. And if I'm not mistaken, if you use Duraline or an equivalent of Duraline with it, you can make them waterproof. That was the word. Because if you use water, it's water activated. If you use water, yeah, then basically if you walk in the rain, whatever, you know, it washes off. But if you use Duraline or an equivalent, it makes them waterproof because you don't use water to activate. So yeah, let me know if you are excited. I will leave her information down below in the description box. And then that is it for today. It was a long one again, wasn't it? Yeah. It is what it is, apparently. So yeah, I'm going to go now and enjoy the day because it's gorgeous weather outside and I have been cooped up inside filming all morning. Yeah, stuff happened. Don't ask. Everything went wrong this morning. I filmed, I tried to film this look. It went horribly wrong because I thought, let me be fancy and put on an orange gel pot eyeliner. Yeah, that did not go well. So I had to redo the look and yeah, it took me an extra hour. Then stuff fell. I cannot speak anymore. It's high time that I quit today's filming session. So yeah, but I have been very productive, which is very, very good. Okay. I'm still here on the side, as you can see, because I want to give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. There's also a link to the merch shop in case you want to browse there. This was it, guys. If you have made it this far, leave me, you know, the flyaway money emoji. Because, I don't know, I think it's fun. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. If you haven't hit the subscribe button yet, I would love it if you would do so. Because I do this video every Friday on my channel. I have a makeup 101 series that is for geared towards older skin that goes usually online on Mondays. For now at least. And I do, yeah, reviews, chatty videos. I have some very fun videos filmed today. I filmed, what did I film? Oh yeah, my best and worst of drugstore, my favorite drugstore brands. Eyeshadow palettes. I have already filmed the indie part and I have, or that one is online, the indie part. And I have filmed the drugstore part yesterday. I also filmed today my spring palettes and this makeup look I filmed, which is done with, I don't know if I mentioned this, this one from Catrice, their peach palette. So yeah, that one is coming as well. A lot of stuff is coming, guys. Truly. Glam Shop Poland is coming. I have the Disney collection from Colourpop that I still want to play with. So make sure that you are subscribed for all the newness and fun that we are going to have on my channel in the upcoming months, weeks, whatever. I'm going to stop now. Yes. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any, didn't I already say that? You know the drill, right? Or at least I hope so. I'm just going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.